Hello, my name is Juetta, and I'll be presenting the research on data science for service design, which was part of my thesis with Marisi. Services are all around us, and they make up for most of the world's GDP. Service design is the discipline that's concerned with these services. Here, service designers model the holistic experience and the service environment. They work typically with a toolbox full of user-centered methods, where the team, the stakeholders, collaboratively analyze and develop. Our world is ever-changing, and I think that Corona is an extreme example of that. Even without the crisis, the growing consumers' demands and increasing complexity of technology puts a lot of pressure on service providers to improve their quality of service, and therefore also on service designers and their teams. And if we look at the changing world, we not only see that it's putting pressure, but there's also a lot of opportunities, and service designers look for this. So for example, the increasing amount of data and data techniques. And it makes a lot of sense. Data science makes use of the increase in data, but it also contributes to the diversity of the designer's methodology toolkit. Those techniques can do things we manually or as a human can't do. And yet, literature is fragmented over multiple areas within data science. Furthermore, to our knowledge, there's no overview that brings those techniques together, and especially in the context of service designers and their needs. Which brings us to the research question: when and how can data science be used to support service designers? The research process consists of three phases: the exploration phase, with shadowing, interviewing, and literature review in order to understand the possibilities, characteristics, and opportunities of both fields. The second phase is ideation, which resulted in a guide to data science methods for service designers. In the last phase, evaluation, designers evaluated the methods and concepts based on their usability and desirability. And the phase also included gathering the overall findings of the design research. Let's get back to service design. Service design is enabling the service provider and the users to co-create value by means of a holistic view and user-centered methods. It's important to note that the use of methods is no fixed script. The methodology highly depends on factors such as the available resources, the team, the project, also the process. In this research, a design process model helped to identify and map the designer's needs and methodologies. The holistic double diamond was selected because it's based on a well-known and used double diamond of the British Design Council. Moreover, it has a broad timeline and includes all activities in distinguished phases for a clearer mapping of the methods. So what's data science? Data science is the field that's concerned with the support and guidance of the extraction of meaningful knowledge from data. The extraction of meaningful or useful knowledge. Working with quantitative data is not enough to call it data science. And I will give you some examples. Classification is the task of assigning instances to predefined categories. For example, placing an email in the inbox or a spam folder. Regression is another example, which aimed at finding and estimating relations between dependent and or independent variables. So for example, the relation between the amount of sunlight and the increase in sick leave. With segmentation, also called clustering, the technique divides instances in meaningful groups based on distinctive features without defining group features. And we will see some more examples later in the presentation. And when we bring those two fields together, we see a number of opportunities that arise. And the first one I want to talk about is the variety of methods. And these are the methods in the designer's toolbox. And it's important that we have a variety of methods because it contributes to our holistic and valid observation with method triangulation, but it also helps us with the applicability and quality in a wide range of projects. But how can data science add to this toolbox? Well, data science methods are techniques are mainly quantitative based and complement the designer's traditional use of qualitative methodologies. But also next to this additional quantitative analysis, data science contributes to a new perspective because it works in a different way. So various knowledge representations or learning techniques can lead to alternative conclusions. And data science techniques can process a lot of information and can pick up small details in this large amount of data. There are also some challenges. So beginning in early stages, you might encounter some technical challenges, especially around the data. So what data do you have? What's its quality? Can it answer the questions you have? Does it fit in your design process at that moment? And even when it answers your questions, it might not be useful in the follow-up phase of your project. And that's also related to the second challenge you might encounter when you're trying to scale up within your company, which is determining the business value. And when you scale up even more, you will notice that the capabilities within your teams might demand new roles, new capabilities, new skills, maybe a different way of communicating that might be difficult to keep within budget. So let's take a look at the guide. And there are four categories: methods that aid in user research, model systems, contribute to creativity, or a way of collaborating between data scientists and service designers. And we'll discuss these nine methods very short. We'll start with opinion mining, which analyzes sentiment and correlations in user-generated content. And it's relatively easy to obtain from social media, reviews, customer feedback. And it informs about the user satisfaction, frustrations, and celebrations. BIA translations help us understand the inner state of our users better by translating signals to inner states. For example, from a heart rate, facial expression, or in this project from brain engineers, EEG data. And it depends on the recording device if the technique is noise sensitive or intrusive, but it tells us more what's going on by translating those signals. Data science can also aid in generating, analyzing, and testing models of complex systems. And with a complex system, I think, for example, about a customer journey. So designers can, with this approach, extract information from the real world, gain insight into the common and specific cases, and simulate environments through virtual models. And I will give some examples. In this example, they build a framework to compare the expected and the actual journey. And the actual journey was constructed based on diary studies and backend logs. And they said that they needed both, because diaries are inaccurate and incomplete, while the backend showed less ad hoc touch points. Next to extracting the actual journeys from digital traces, the next step would be to analyze this data. When we have extracted the data to see what the actual journeys are, we can take a step further and analyze with data science whether it's common journeys, divergent journeys, but also moreover predict. So if you have a live user and you can see certain steps, then these kinds of models can predict what's the likely next step for this user. With data-driven design, we create a lot of insights, but also within our teams and projects, information about our clients, deliverables, artifacts, everything. That's a lot of data. And we can build data-driven systems to analyze and explore, highlight certain relevant patterns and information. For example, during onboarding, kickoff, or analyze for higher level insights across domains. By generating artifacts, data science can help us with inspiration, additional information, or efficiency, such as an autocomplete to prototypes and testing. But it also can be another player in our brainstorm. We talked briefly about segmentation before. So it can reveal patterns and form groups based on non-predefined characteristics. This provides an alternative view about users or products, and in this way, previously unknown user behavior could be found. So in this example, there's data from public transport in Canada. And with segmentation, the algorithm found four groups of behavior, and this is based on check-in and check-out date stamps. And we see certain behavioral groups. But if we compare that to the marketing-based groups, we can see that students can have different kinds of patterns during the day, while for elderly, there's one dominant behavior. We can use this to, for example, have different activities during the day targeted at the students or elderly. The last category is about working efficiently together, and it's not based on a specific data science technique. For example, visualizing can help communication between team members. So what can we conclude? Among our findings is that data science methods contribute to the diversity of the designer's methodology toolkit. And it will increase the validity of user research because of method triangulation. It can make hidden information accessible and help designers with their creative process. This will mean that we have to integrate data science in our design projects. For example, other data sources have to be created, but also the roles within the team might change. As a result, we'll have robuster user research, more understanding in their behaviors and inner states, and a more creative design process. Can be more efficient, but also more collaborative or inspiring. It's good to note that this research was explorative and pretty broad. It was evaluated with a small group of designers from a single company. So it's important that for further research to expand this research and increase depth and validity. To conclude, the iterative research process resulted in a guide to data science methods for service designers. And it fills the gap between service design teams and the fragmented and technical literature, and is validated with service designers and explicitly addresses their needs. By analyzing the guides, this research has shown an overview of the diverse ways that data science can support service designers. The guide and the methods can assist design agencies, service designers, and their teams in organizing, selecting, and utilizing these data techniques. Thank you for listening.